Good morning, students. Today, as we in the last class, we have finished the topic, that is chemical effects of electric current. So today we start with the, before you start with the next chapter, we'll go through the revision part of chemical effects of electric current. So first of all, we learnt about conductors, insulators, then who conducts electricity, and who is a good conductor of electricity, who is a bad conductor of electricity, then what are the chemical effects of electric current, what are the normal effects of electric current, what is the heating effect, what is the magnetic effect. These are the things we learned. So just today, recorded class, will be a quick recap of the chapter chemical effects of electric current. So this topic we taught in 17 November. The learning outcome was analyze the testing of different liquids of conduction of electricity. So similar to many solids, some liquids also conduct electricity. We have conductors, we have insulators, and the substances which allow electricity to pass through them are called conductors, and substances which do not allow electricity to pass through them are called insulators. So conductors, you have gold, acidic solution, salt solution, and insulators, you have insulators, plastic, rubber, these are the things. So these things you will be getting here in this particular chapter which you already did. So coming to the next topic, we have use of a circuit tester. So generally we use a circuit tester to test whether the material is an electrical conductor or insulator. If it is a conductor, it will pass current. If it is an insulator, it will not pass the current. So for example, example of a circuit tester is given in this particular diagram. There is a battery, there are two wires connected to a bulb, and those two wires you can connect to the metal or to the solution or whatever to check whether that particular thing is conducting electricity or not. Okay. Next we have how to use a circuit tester. So we can use a circuit tester as shown in the setup. Step number one, you will connect the battery, bulb, and the wires will put separately, and then whatever object you want to test whether it will conduct or not, that object you can put at the end of the wire. So you can place the object between the open ends of the wire or the crocodile clips, which we call it crocodile clips. So you can put it and you can check whether it is conducting electricity or not. How to use circuit tester. Now, if the bulb which you have connected, the battery you have, the bulb we have, and the wires we have. Suppose the object which you have given, and with the bulb which you have connected, if the bulb lights up, which means current is passing through the battery, through the circuit, and through the object. So if the bulb lights up, it means material allows electric current to flow through the circuit. As simple as that. And the brighter the bulb, the better is the conductor. Because if the bulb glows like a dim light, then which means the current is not passing properly. So if the current is not passing properly, which means the light is not proper, or the material is not proper conductor. For the material to be a proper conductor, light should pass, current should pass properly, and the bulb should glow brightly. So if the bulb lights up, it means the material allows electric current to pass through the circuit, and the brighter the bulb, the better is the conductor of electricity. Next, we have good conductors and bad conductors. So substances which allow electric current to pass through them are called good conductors. And substances allows electric current to pass through them, but very little. So they are called bad conductors. So when you pass the current nicely, good conductors, and when you pass the current very slowly, bad conductors. And when you do not pass the current at all, that is called insulator. So there are three types: good conductors, bad conductors, insulators. Next, examples. So electrical conductors which allow the materials that allow the electric current to pass through. You have copper, you have silver, you have aluminium, you have graphite. So these are the things are good conductors. They allow current to pass through. So these materials will be called good conductors of electricity. Then you have insulator. So insulators are materials which don't allow the current to pass through. Rubber is an insulator, wood is an insulator, plastic is an insulator. So these are the different types of insulator which do not allow the current to pass through. Liquids. As I already told you, liquids which contain salt, this part where I was explaining the part is very important chapter point topic. Liquids which contain salt dissolved in them conduct electricity, and it can be tested whether by connecting a bulb. So but the liquids which do not have any salt solution are not a good conductor, because salt solution only diffuses into ions, and those ions are responsible for conduction of electricity. As simple as that. So this is a setup. You need a magnetic compass, you need a battery, you need the open ends of a wire, and you need to put in the liquid. When you put in the liquid, if the magnet shows some deflection, or if the light bulb glows, which means that particular solution is conducting. Otherwise, that particular solution is non-conducting. Suppose I take this bottle of water. Now, if I take this bottle of water and I insert to, suppose I have taken this bottle of water and these are the ends of the tester and I have inserted two things. So these are the ends of the tester. This is connected to a battery and the battery is connected to a bulb. So if I put inside and the bulb glows, which means this is a good conductor electricity. And if I put inside and the bulb does not glow, which means this is a bad conductor electricity. So depending on the liquids should have salt solution. Because if they have salt solution, which means they can conduct electricity properly. And salt solution dissolves into ions. So I can make this water conducting by putting some acid or by putting some base. I can make it conducting. Okay. Next, salts. So salts dissolved in water are responsible for conduction of electricity. Tap water, acid solution, basic solution are all good conductors. But distilled water is a poor conductor. Because distilled water does not contain any kind of salt. The water which you use in batteries, distilled water. So, you have to place the two aluminum plates. You can detect whether aluminum conducts electricity or not. We have to place the two aluminum plates into the liquid tester. If the bulb lights up, a closed circuit is formed, allowing the current to flow. And the liquid is a conductor of electricity. As I told you, this is a liquid. I put the ends. If the bulb lights up, then this particular liquid is a good conductor of electricity. Otherwise, not. So these are some liquids which are good conductors: tap water, salt solution, hydrochloric acid, sodium hydroxide, and distilled water, sugar solution, kerosene, spirit. These are all bad conductors. You can see in the circuit, the bulb is glowing or not. You've connected this battery, the bulb glows, the metal rods, sodium chloride solution you have taken. Sodium chloride is a salt. You can see in this particular diagram, sodium chloride is a salt, so it will conduct electricity. So current is passing through and the bulb is glowing. But you have taken here in one figure, in the middle figure, the bulb is not glowing. So in the middle figure, if the bulb is not glowing, which means the solution is not conducting. In the first and the third figure, the bulb is glowing, which means the solution is conducting. Clear? So whenever a solution conducts electricity, which means the circuit is complete. Or the solution is a good conductor, otherwise not. Chemical effects. So as we all know that different effects, we have three types of effects. Chemical effects, magnetic effect, heating effect. In chemical effect, we can see bubbles. In chemical effect, we can see color change. In chemical effect, we can see current passing through. In heating effect, we can see the bulb is glowing. And in magnetic effect, we can see that the compass is showing reflection. So the compass shows deflection, means magnetic effect. The bulb, the filament of the bulb glows, which was heating effect. And if bubbles are being produced, for example, when you pass current through water, bubbles are produced. There is a chemical effect. Sometimes the color gets changed. There is a chemical effect. So these are some of the chemical effects of electric current. When electric current is passed through a solution of metal salt, the metal gets deposited. Electroplating, chemical effect. The first point number B is electroplating. Point number A, when electric current is passed through water, bubbles are formed, chemical effect. Sometimes the color of the solution changes when electric current passes through, chemical effect. So these are all chemical effects. Then, as I already told you, this is the setup for the chemical effects of electric current. You have electrodes. The cathode is negatively charged. The anode is positively charged because the cathode is connected to the negative terminal. The anode is connected to the positive terminal. Electroplating, we discussed in the last class nicely. Electroplating means the process of coating a metal with another metal. So, on a metal, you coat on a metal with another metal. So, the metal which is to be coated should be connected to the negative terminal. Remember, the metal which is to be coated should be connected to the negative terminal. And the metal with which you will coat should be connected to the positive terminal. The metal which you will coat should be connected to the positive terminal. And the metal with which you are coating, this is the metal with which I am coating this. So this should be in the positive, and the metal which I am coating, this should be in the negative. For example, last class I give you an experiment. You have to gold plate a spoon with the help of gold. The spoon is metallic spoon. So the spoon you will connect to the negative terminal and gold you will connect to the positive terminal. When you pass the current, when you switch on the battery, when you pass the current, the gold solution dissociates and the gold from the solution goes to the cathode. The impure one, the negative one, goes to the cathode where the metal to be coated is kept, that is the spoon. So when current is passed through, gold from the solution, remember when current is passed through, gold